Hello students, in this topic we'll deal basically the importance of human rights education. That why is human rights education so important? Education is one, the simple manifestation of the man. Everyone has a right to seek and receive information about all the human rights and all the fundamental freedoms. And one should also have access to human rights education and the training. It gives the insights of the significance of the human rights education and the role of United Nations in promoting the human rights through its international documents and the declarations. This lecture and this PPT also discuss the international and national scenario of the human rights education. Now, we'll deal with the points that why do human rights matter. Human rights ensure people have basic needs met. Everyone needs access to medicine, food, clothing, and shelter. By including these in a person's basic human rights, everyone has a baseline level of the dignity. Unfortunately, there are still millions of the people out there who don't have these basic necessities, but saying that it's a matter of human rights which allows activities and others to work towards getting those for free for everyone. Second point is human rights protect vulnerable groups from abuse. The Declaration of the Human Rights was created largely because of the Holocaust and the horrors of the WII. During that time in history, the most vulnerable in society were targeted along with the Jewish population, including those with the disabilities and the LGBT. Organizations concerned with human rights focus on members of the society most vulnerable to abuse from power holders instead of ignoring them. Human rights allow people to stand up to societal corruption. The concept of the human rights allows people to speak up when they experience abuse and corruption. This is why specific rights like the right to assemble are so crucial, because no society is perfect. The concept of the human rights empowers people and tells them that they deserve dignity from the society, whether it's the government or their work environment. When they don't receive it, they can stand up. Next, human rights encourage freedom of speech and expression. While similar to what you just studied above, being able to speak freely without fear or brutal reprisal is more expensive. It encompasses ideas and forms of expressions that not everybody will like or agree with, but no one should ever feel like they are going to be in any danger from the government because of what they think. It goes both ways too and protects people who want to debate or argue with certain ideas expressed in their society. Then comes the human rights give people the freedom to practice their religion or not practice any of the religion. Religious violence and the oppression occur over and over again all across history, from the Crusades to the Holocaust to modern terrorism in the name of their religion. Human rights acknowledges the importance of a person's religion and spiritual beliefs and lets them practice in peace. The freedom to not to hold a religion is also a human right. Next comes human rights also allows people to love who they choose. The importance of a freedom to love cannot be understood. Being able is to choose what one's romantic life look like is an essential human right. The consequence of not protecting this right are clear when you look at the countries where LGBT peoples are oppressed and abused, or where the women are forced into marriages they don't want to do. Next comes human rights encourage equal opportunities. The right to work and make a living allows people to flourish in their society without acknowledging that the work environment can be biased or downright oppressive. People find themselves enduring abuse or insufficient opportunities. The concept of human rights provide a guide for how workers should be treated and encourages equality. Then comes human rights give people access to education. Education is important for so many reasons and is so crucial for the societies where poverty is common. Organizations and governments concerned with the human rights provide access to schooling, supplies and more in order to halt the cycle of the poverty. Seeing education as a right means everyone can get access, not just the elite. Next point is human rights protect the environment. The marriage between the human rights and the environmentalism is becoming so stronger due to climate change and the effects it has so on the people. We live in the world, we need the land, so it makes sense that what happens to the environment impacts the humanity. The right to clean air, clean soil and clean water are all as important as the other rights included in this list. Now, the last point, human rights provide a universal standard that holds the government accountable. When the UDHR was released, it had a twofold purpose. First is provide a guideline for the future and force the world to acknowledge that during WWII, human rights had been violated on a massive scale. With standard for what is a human right, governments can be held accountable for their actions. There's a power in naming an injustice and pointing to a precedent, which makes the UDHR and the other human right documents so much important. I hope the topic must be clear to you. Thank you so much, students.